The second condition that should be met for the customer to have the right to control the use of the asset is that the customer should have the right to direct the use of that asset during the period of use. This right allows the customer to decide about how the asset will be used, and for what purpose it will be used, and also allows the customer to revise these decisions anytime during the period of use. These decisions should be relevant. And by relevant we mean that they should affect the economic benefits to be derived from the use of the asset. Deciding about whether to produce the output, and of what type, when, where, and how much to be produced from that output, are examples of the decisions that affect the economic benefits to be derived from the asset. Relevant decisions may vary between different contracts, depending on the nature of the asset, and the terms and conditions of the contract. For example, in a contract where the customer is granted the right to use shipping containers for transportation of its goods, the decisions might involve deciding whether to use a shipping container to transport goods, or to use it for storage purposes, when to use the containers to ship the goods to its destination, which destinations the goods will be shipped to, and the quantities to be shipped. Another example, a contract where the customer is granted the right to use a retail unit to sell its goods, the decisions might involve deciding what mix of products to be sold from the retail unit, when to sell specific goods, for example seasonal goods, and deciding the amount of goods to be held as inventory in the retail store. On the other side, there are other decisions that are irrelevant. They don't affect the economic benefits to be derived from the use of the asset. They are limited only to the operation and maintenance of the asset. And although these decisions are essential to the efficient use of the asset, they don't grant the customer or the supplier any right to direct the use of the asset. For example, assume we have a contract where the supplier grants the customer the right to use a retail unit. According to the terms of the contract, the supplier only provides security and maintenance. Here, although these services are essential for the efficient use of the retail unit, they don't give the supplier any right to direct the use of the asset. It is only the customer who can direct the use of the asset, and decide about how the asset is used, and for what purpose it is used. Sometimes, the decisions about directing the use of the asset are predetermined, before the period of use starts. This is the case when both the supplier and the customer agree about them in the contract. Here, the customer does not have the right to direct the use of the asset during the period of use, unless one of the following two conditions is satisfied. The customer has the right to operate the asset throughout the period of use, where the supplier cannot interfere with the customer's operating procedures. Or, the customer designed the asset in a way that predetermines how it will be used, and for what purpose it will be used. So if the decisions are predetermined, and one of these two conditions is satisfied, then the customer still has the right to direct the use of the asset during the period of use. Example: a one-year contract, where the customer is granted the right to use a vehicle to transport its goods to several specific destinations. The contract specified what goods to be transported, when, where, and the quantity of goods to be transported. The customer will be responsible only for the operation of the vehicle, and deciding about the details of each trip. Here, the decisions about directing the use of the vehicle are predetermined in the contract before the period of use starts. In addition, the customer has the right to operate the vehicle during the period of use. Therefore, the customer has the right to direct the use of the asset during the period of use. Another example, a contract, where the customer is granted the right to use a production line in a factory owned by the supplier. The contract specified how and for what purpose the production line will be used, by referring to the production plan that spells out the goods to be produced, when and how much to be produced. The customer was allowed to make some modifications to the design of the production line before the period of use, to suit its production needs. The supplier is responsible only for the operation and the maintenance of the production line. Here, the customer has the right to direct the use of the production line. Decisions about directing the use of the production line are predetermined in the contract before the period of use, and the customer has designed the production line before the period of use. The fact that the supplier is just operating the production line does not grant the supplier any rights to direct its use. If the contract includes a defined scope of use, then all decisions that involve directing the use of the asset should be exercised by the customer within the defined scope of use. Note that the defined scope of using the asset does not prevent the customer from having the right to direct the use of the asset. For example, a supplier might restrict a customer from storing flammable material in its warehouse to protect the supplier's interest in it. Here, this restriction does not prevent the customer from directing the use of the warehouse because the customer can still decide what goods to be stored in the warehouse, except for those prohibited by the supplier. Now, let's work out the next question.